Shares in Checkpoint Software hit a 12-year high yesterday. That's after the Israeli network security firm reported earnings that beat estimates. The news capped a big week for Israel and cyber companies, with a major industry gathering and news of investments from the likes of Lockheed and EMC2. Our Middle East editor Elliot Gotkin has more. Good morning, Elliot.
Morning, Mark. Yes, well, for more on that, I'm joined by Dr. Orna Berry, who is a corporate vice president at EMC and also the head of its center of excellence here in Israel. Orna, good morning to you.
Good morning.
We were talking about this investment that you and Lockheed Martin were making, $1 million in Ben-Gurion University. What exactly is that money for?
This money is for research and development at the university in the areas of big data, in the area of cloud computing, and in the area of cybersecurity. The reason why it is those three areas, this is where the information technology is migrating to, and that's the need, and university is very strong in cyber and in big data, so we're there.
And earlier this week at this Cybertech gathering of industry leaders, you met with Prime Minister Netanyahu, and I think a lot of Israeli cyber startups were there. We know there's more than 200 here in Israel already. Did you see any that took your fancy? EMC's invested, spent $2 billion on acquisitions in Israel over the years. Any cyber companies take your fancy? Are you on the lookout for acquisitions?
Yeah, actually, I think Lockheed Martin, EMC, RSA, the Prime Minister, we were looking together at the venture capital community and at many of the startup companies, and there is very great strength here. EMC by itself in Israel is built from acquisitions, and the part of RSA, which is the security division of EMC in Israel, is a result of the acquisition of Sayota, the company that Naftali Bennett was the entrepreneur of.
Israel's economy minister, of course.
Right.
And speaking of the Prime Minister, we were speaking with him just the other day and talking about the strength of the Israeli shekel. It's the best performing currency in the world over the last few months or year or so, against 31 currencies trapped by Bloomberg. How painful is a strong shekel for a multinational like EMC with big operations in Israel?
It is very, very bad for all exporting companies, because the strong shekel makes everything that is done in Israel much less competitive in the cost performance area, and that is a killer. So we definitely, as a local industry, multinational, electronic industries, high-tech industries, we are all pledging for the government and the Bank of Israel to take the right measures to put us on par so we're back into the competitive zone. And it's been an attrition.
And Netanyahu actually said, when we asked him what he was going to do, he said, I tell our exporters, who are very nimble mammals, that ultimately you have to adjust. What do you say to that?
So there is always an adjustment, but there are some adjustments that we don't like to see, and that's shrinking. And we do see occasional shrinking because of the adjustments.
Are you shrinking? Are you laying off people, for example, because of this?
We are not shrinking at this moment, because we have some very critical technologies to the corporate, and the corporate is scaling them out in other markets. But certainly always the question comes up, regardless of the talent in Israel, the cost is a major issue, major.
And would it prevent you from investing more?
It will cap the investment, because you always look at the return on the investment, and the return on the investment, if the key element in the high tech area is human capital, and human capital is out of range relative to their productivity, then you cannot work that way. And Bank of Israel has published that the high-tech sector is almost as productive as it is in the United States. So think about people who are working endless hours and very fast into market and are still not as productive as in the United States. It's all about the currency.
Okay, Dr. Orna Berry, we hope that the Prime Minister and the Bank of Israel is watching and listening. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. Dr. Orna Berry, the Corporate Vice President of EMC and the General Manager of its Center of Excellence here in Israel. I'll hand it back to you in London.
Thanks, Elliot. Elliot Gotkin there at the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange.